Anybody has a question? Where is? Yes, ask. You can ask.
Can I ask to you, Guruji?
Who is question? Guruji, yeah.
Guruji, the sentence, I see the flower. How come it is two thoughts using idam vritti, I and the object, the subject and the object.
Right.
And we have divided this one sentence into two thoughts.
There is no one sentence. There is one experience. When child sees the flower, what is the experience?
Seeing the flower.
But is there feeling of, there is an experience, there is no seeing of the flower also. This is just experience for the child. Because there is no thoughts.
Okay.
So thoughts come and break that experience into two thoughts or multiple thoughts.
Okay.
See, child has no mind. The mind is not developed. So every experience of child is experience of oneness, one experience. So for you also, there's one experience only. But the one experience gets cut with the thoughts. This not, I am seeing the flower is not one thought. It's one experience.
Okay.
Right? If you didn't have mind, that would be one experience. That one experience of one whole, one reality.
Right.
But that experience gets cut into multiple thoughts because of mind.
Okay.
Right? Yeah, anybody else has a question? Please raise your hand. Yes? Yes?
Guruji, I had a question. I posted it in the group.
Yeah, you can repeat the question for the benefit of all the people.
So, you said that to see the world as it is, we have to go beyond your instruments. So then how does our body, how do we get to know what's the world without any way to...
Yeah, see, when you go beyond, you have to see the reality, you have to go beyond the instruments. The beyond the instrument means not just blocking the instruments or not having the instruments. Okay? So there's a mind and body. When the mind is silent, right? Then how do you experience the world?
With no thoughts.
With no thoughts, there's an experience of oneness, right?
Yeah.
That's going beyond the mind. Right? So there's an experience, but there's no naming of the experience. The thoughts don't come and break the experience. Then you see the reality. It is one real, one big real, one whole. The mind comes and breaks the experience into pieces, like blind people trying to figure out an elephant. Oh, this is elephant. He touches the leg and says, this is elephant. Mind is like a blind, mind just keeps cutting the experience into small, small pieces. When the mind is silent and you experience the world, silence is thoughtless, then you experience the world as one whole. You understand?
Okay. Yeah.
So next question, please.
Prabhuji, I have.
Yes.
Prabhuji, you told the five sense organs are the blind men. How are they the blind men, Prabhuji?
No, they are like blind men. They are not blind men.
Yeah, that's what. How are they like the blind men?
See, you are able to see me, right?
Yeah, I'm able.
Okay. Is your eye as sharp as the eagle's eye?
No.
Eagle eye is much bigger, sharper, right?
Yeah.
You are able to hear, but can you hear like a bat?
No.
You are able to smell. Can you smell like a dog?
No.
Dog can smell 1 kilometer away, right?
Yeah.
So basically what happens is our sense organs are limited. Their ability is limited. Right? You cannot see the entire picture, full picture. Even bat's eye or eagle's eye, they are also limited.
Okay.
Right?
Something more than that, something which can compete that, also is there for eagle?
No, there's not. Even if you take everything, still they are small. They are not comprehend, able to comprehend the God.
Okay.
God is
but in
between.
In competitors, some competitors will be forever.
No, it's not about competitors. It is the ability. Even with our best instruments, still the God is infinity. So to see the infinity, we don't have the ability instruments.
Yeah.
Right? In that sense, we are blind. It's not the blind in the sense we are not able to see. We are able to see, but we are able to see only limited. When this reality is unlimited.
Yeah.
You got it?
Yeah, and are also the five sense organs the instruments of our body?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So next question. Anybody has a question, please?
Prabhuji, I have a question.
Yes.
Prabhuji, when yesterday I was listening to the last video, that is the witness consciousness, somebody was asking that how does the linking happen?
Linking of what happens?
You answered it, linking of two thoughts.
Okay.
Then you said that it is happening by Chidabhasa. That was a bit unclear to me actually.
See, you can take all this, you can take everything as a movie and a screen example, right? In the movie, there are two characters, Rama and Ravana. So, in a movie plot, they appear to be related. Rama is related to Ravana, Rama is fighting a war with Ravana and all. But both are characters, both are not related. They are just a projection on the screen, right? But they appear to be connected and their storyline is unfolding. Why? The screen is there. Correct? Without the screen, the storyline will not unfold. The characters will not be related. So similarly, Atma or the consciousness is the background on which all thoughts appear and disappear. Thoughts are like characters. They are not related to each other. But they appear to be related to each other because of the background, not because of themselves related.
Okay.
See, for example, you have a thought, let's say this is a cup is a thought. Okay. So I know cup is a thought.
Yeah.
Okay. A thought is just an object. I know is an object. The one who knows is an object. A cup is object. They are not related.
Correct.
The relationship happens because of the consciousness which is there in the background. Right?
Correct. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, anybody else? Okay. Next.
Yeah. So, I by this I understand one thing, that if Ravana is also having, he's linking the thoughts, and Rama is also linking the thoughts, like they are projecting the same things, but the background is same for both. That's why
yes.
It is getting connected.
Correct. Background is all same.
Thank you.
There's only one background.
Okay.
The background is Atma and the Atma is the background for everybody.
Shared consciousness. Shared.
Not shared. It's only one consciousness. There's no sharing.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Welcome. Anybody else has a question, please? Yes, Rajini?
Guruji, with the witness consciousness, I felt it was so scientifically taken up. The approach was so scientific.
Mm-hmm.
That is, it was to the nature of the mind and the nature of the ego.
Right.
And it was so deep, Guruji, that people today, in fact, in India also, they say about 5 in 1 people is under mental illness, which could be depression or anything.
Right.
This talk had so much of depth.
Right.
It can... You know, even if not going the spiritual path, even just understanding the nature of your mind and the nature of ego can, you know, can cure so many mental illnesses.
Definitely.
Let alone the spirituality, the depth of the spirituality.
Yeah, definitely. No. See, we are taught in the school, everything ever we are taught in the school. We are taught in the school how to science, mathematics, physics, chemistry. We are taught about how to become successful, how to become competitive. We are not taught anything. We are taught zero about ourselves, right? So that actually in the earlier day, the education was focused on know about yourself and know about the subject. That's what Gurukula was. So now the whole focus on this self is gone, Atma is gone. So that's why people go through a lot of trouble, a lot of disturbance. Right? Anyway, we cannot correct the system, we have to correct ourselves. Right? So anybody else has a question? Others, shall we start?
Prabhuji, I have.
Yeah, voice. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Prabhuji, you told like non-duality also is Atma Darshan of that. Even is it then duality, Dvaita?
Ask you a question. Can you clearly ask the question?
Is in Advaita Vedanta you told Atma Darshana meditation is a part of it. And even as Dvaita Vedanta, is meditation a part of it?
See, Dvaita, whenever you experience something, it's Dvaita.
Okay.
When you know who is the experience, it's Advaita.
Okay.
Right? So, you are talking to me, this is Dvaita.
Okay.
But you understand the one who talks and one who listens is Atma, then it's Advaita, the reality.
But how? But we both are talking, what you told like duality, how, what are we experiencing?
What you are experiencing?
Like how you talk and the way you talk.
No. Experience is two types. No, one is experience as an object, and you experience yourself all the time. No.
Yeah.
Right. That is Atma. That is God.
Okay.
Not as a body. The one who knows the body. Awareness.
Okay.
Right. So that is God. So we are deep inside. We are God, and while experience the world, we are human beings. Like that, you can think that this is just an instrument of God.
Okay.
Okay.
And Prabhuji, one more question.
Yes.
Last week you told for you I am Atma, for others I am the body. If you ask who you are, if you ask, because you have taught me Atma Jnana and all, she will tell like I am Atman to you.
Yes. Not to anybody else. Okay.
Prabhuji, but if somebody is there, should I, then if you ask, should I tell I'm Atman?
Then I won't ask.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, let us start. Okay. So I'll share a screen. You please look at that. So you are able to see the screen? Are you able to see the screen? There are chakras, right?
Yes, good.
Okay. So we had a look at the Annamaya Kosha, the first outer layer of body, right? Last session. The physical body. We went through observing the physical body. Correct? You remember? All of you remember?
Yeah.
So when you observe the physical body, you are not the body. You are the witness, Sakshi, right? Now we will go to the inner body, next body. Next body is Pranamaya Kosha. First is outer body is called Annamaya Kosha. The inner body is called Pranamaya Kosha. Right? You remember all those or you don't? Okay. So we have five layers, right? Annamaya, Pranamaya, Manomaya, Vidnanamaya, Anandamaya. Now we are going to Pranamaya Kosha. So the Pranamaya Kosha is, Prana is controls the whole body, right? So for example, I want to lift my hand like this. Okay. So then the mind says I have to lift my hand. Then the Prana energy has to move. Understand? So the body is controlled by mind is the controller, the body is controlled through prana, energy. Correct? So how do you get the energy? Through food. Correct? And through breath. To food and breath you get the energy. So if you don't take food, the mind, the body will become weak. The mind will not be able to control the body. If you don't take breath, then also you will not be able to control the body. So the breath flows through, the prana flows through our, throughout our body in the form of through nerves. Prana, nerves, right? There are nerves in the body. How hand is controlled by the nerves. So the prana is distributed throughout the body. The consciousness in the brain controls the entire body through prana. Is this clear to all? The consciousness flows in the brain, nervous system, the spinal cord, and through all nerve centers. And with that you control the body. So pranamaya kosha is deeper than the annamaya kosha, and it's bigger also. Annamaya kosha looks, physical body looks bigger. Pranamaya kosha, becomes being subtle, is bigger than annamaya kosha. Right? So the pranamaya, the mind controls the body through six centers called chakras. Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha, Adna, Sahasrara. See, Mooladhara is, this, all these chakras are located in the spinal cord, in the nervous system. Right? Mooladhara is at the base of the spine. Swadhisthana is slightly above, Manipura is slightly above, Anahata is slightly above, Adna is here, Vishuddha is here, Adna is here, and Sahasrara is here. So what are these chakras? Chakras are like points which, by which mind controls the body. It's like you can think this is a steering wheel or gear by which the mind controls the body. Right? So today we are going to become aware of the pranic body, the pranamaya kosha. So how do you become aware of pranic body? Just close your eyes and become aware of your breath. There is a movement of breath. That breath movement is caused by prana. And how does the breath movement happen? Because of energy in the spinal cord. Energy moves in the spinal cord. Signals come in the spinal cord. Your heart beats, your digestive system operates, the blood flow happens. All these are controlled by prana, pranic energy. Okay, so you can feel these movements of heartbeat, breath, and lungs. All those movements you can feel, but controlling energy we don't feel, because the controlling energy is in the spinal cord, brain, nervous system. Are you able to understand? So let us go slightly inwards now. From annamaya kosha we'll go to pranamaya kosha and experience that. Okay, we have to become aware of that. That's all. Why do you have to become aware? Whatever I become, whatever I see, I am not that. I am the seer. The seen is appearance. So, if I see my hand, I am not my hand. If I see my body, I am not the body. See means seeing, feeling, experiencing, all those included. Are you able to feel the mind? Do you feel the mind? Are you able to see the mind? So, you are able to see the body, right? Are you able to see the mind? Namit?
Prabhuji?
Are you able to see the mind?
Mind, no.
Seeing means feeling. No. Do you know that there are thoughts in the mind? So that's why you see the mind. It's not seeing through eyes. When you know something is seen.
Okay.
So there is knower and known. Who am I?
Witness.
Witness is the knower.
Yeah.
Right? I'm not.
Knowing principle.
Huh?
Knowing principle.
Knowing principle, correct. So we have to gradually separate. Okay, I'm not the body, I'm not the breath, I'm not the prana, like that you have to separate out one by one. By seeing, by experiencing it. Okay? So let us start. Close your eyes, sit silently. Gently close your eyes, sit in a meditative posture. We are making inward journey into the self. Gently become aware of your breath. Gently breathe in, breathe out. Gently and slowly breathe in, breathe out. Reduce the speed of breathing from 10 to 12 breath per minute to slow down. Slow, deep breath. 5 to 6 breath per minute. Breathe down deep into the abdomen. Slow breath, deep breath. I am observer of breath. I am observing the breath. I am the witness. Breath is an object. Breath changes, but I don't change. I am the sakshi, the witness. I am the witness, I am pure consciousness, I am peaceful, blissful. Deep breathing, slow breathing. The breath is the rein, the mind is the horse. The breath is used for controlling the mind. Shift your attention to the left leg. Visualize the breath enters into the left leg. When you breathe in, fills up the entire left leg all the way up to fingers, and when you breathe out, it goes out from the left leg through the nose. So use the breath to guide your attention. Experience the left leg fully, the finger, the feet, the knee, the leg and thigh. Feel the sensation. I am able to experience the left leg. That's why I am the experiencer. Left leg is experienced. I am not the leg. I am the experiencer of the leg. I am the witness, the knowing principle. I am the witness, peaceful, blissful. Gently guide your breath into the right leg, all the way up to the fingers, toe. Experience the sensations in the right leg. Small sensations. Become aware of all the sensations in the right leg. The experience in the left leg keep changing, sensations keep changing, but I am the witness. Witness doesn't change. I am the knowing principle. I am peaceful. I am blissful. I am not the left leg, I am not the right leg. Gently take your awareness to the stomach area. Feel the sensations in the stomach area. Gently use the breath to guide your awareness of stomach area. I am not the body, I am not the stomach, I am not the left leg, I am not the right leg, I am the witness, I am pure consciousness, blissful. become aware of the chest, guide the breath into chest area. Feel the sensations in chest area. Gently shift your attention to the back. Experience the back fully. Guide the breath into the back. Feel every inch of the back. Feel the sensations. I am able to experience the back. I am not the back. I am the witness. I am the sakshi. As witness, I am blissful, peaceful. I am not the left leg, right leg, stomach, chest and back. Gently shift your attention to both the hands. Breathe in into the both the hands and breathe out. Experience the both the hands fully. Feel the sensation. I am able to experience both the hands. I am the witness, Sakshi. There are changes in my hand, but I am witness free from all changes. I am unchanging. I am peaceful and blissful. Gently shift your attention to the neck, the face, the ears and the head. Breathe in and breathe out into the neck, face, ears and head. Feel the sensation. Sensations keep changing, but I, the witness, am unchanging. I am the witness. Witness is blissful, peaceful. I am not the face, I am not the head, I am not the neck, I am not the ears, I am witness of these, I am pure consciousness, Sakshi, I am peaceful and blissful. we have gone through the entire Annamaya Kosha from leg to head, head to leg. All these are non-self. I am not the body. Because I am able to experience the body and witness the body, I am not the body. I am the witness, consciousness. Now let us take to our attention to Pranamaya Kosha. Annamaya Kosha is over, Pranamaya Kosha. Gently visualize this energy moving into the spine, from the base of the spine all the way up to Adna. Breathe in from the Mooladhara to Adna. Gently guide your attention from base of the spine Adna or eyebrow center. When you breathe in from Mooladhara all the way up to Adna. When you breathe out from Adna to Mooladhara, in visualization, visualize like that. Gently, slowly breathe in, breathe out. Continue for some time. Slow breath. Deep breath. Breathe in from Mooladhara to Swadhisthana to Manipura, Anahata, Vishuddha into Adna to the eyebrow center and reverse again from Adna to Vishuddha, Anahata, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Mooladhara. Keep breathing in, breathe out. Become aware, more and more aware of spinal cord and the brain inside using this breath as a tool. mind becomes more and more calm and peaceful. Enjoy the peace and silence. Gently take your attention to Ajna Chakra, the forehead center, the place just above eyebrows where you put kumkum. Gently look into that center. Just observe whatever is going on, maybe sensation, maybe pulsation. Gently be aware of Ajna Chakra while you continue the background, breathe in, breathe out, slowly, naturally. Gently shift your attention to the top of the head, the crown center. become aware of sensations at the crown center. Breathe in, breathe out, into the Sahasrara, gently and slowly. Gently take your attention to the inner space in the body from head to toe. There is emptiness within the body. Become aware of that inner space. Gently guide your attention to the chest cavity, the cavity in the chest, within the chest. There's a feeling of I amness in the body. Stay with the feeling of I amness. I am the witness, Sakshi. Stay as witness. I am one with the inner space. The inner space and outer space are one and the same. I am one with the infinite space. Gently bring your awareness to the body. Feel the sensations in the body, head, the neck, the chest, the legs. Become aware of your breathing. I'll chant now. You can repeat after me. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Lokaha Samastaha सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु हरिः ओम् श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम् नानु नानेम्बुदु नानल्ल ई देह मन बुद्धि नानल्ल सचिदानंदात्म शिवनानु नानी शिवोहम 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 आत्मदर्शनम ब्रह्मदर्शनम ब्रह्मदर्शनम सत्यदर्शनम Gently rub both our hands and give arm to eyes and slowly open your eyes. So, do you feel peaceful? So, this is the way. By observing the body, I am not the body. By observing the breath, I am not the breath. By observing the pranamaya kosha, I am not the pranamaya kosha. Like that, we have to go deeper. And deeper. Is that clear to all? Anybody has a question or a doubt? Please raise your hand if you have a question or a doubt. Yes? 1 minute.
Help for studies like concentrating or anything for focus, will it help us?
You tell me.
I think it may be. Because focusing, even when we see with our eyes, also we can focus the same, I think.
So now, what is your question?
My question was here, like, we had a question, does this help in studies, this Agna Chakra concentration method?
So, my question is, what do you think?
It's possible.
It is possible or it helps?
It helps both. It's possible and...
Anywhere to make the mind very silent and peaceful, it helps.
Okay.
Alright? More important, we'll get tensed up. Exam, fear, corona, all those tension will come. Learn how to become mind, make the mind peaceful. Then you can focus anything.
Okay.
So anybody else has a question? Yes, Sheetal?
Prabhuji, what is the difference between Chittakasha and Chidakasha?
What is the difference between sun and reflection of sun in water?
The sun is the actual source and the one which is the moon is a reflection of the source.
Correct. So like that, only Atma, one Atma is there. Okay?
Okay.
What is the nature of Atma? Awareness. Pure awareness. The knowing principle.
Yeah.
That is called Chidakasha. The space of consciousness. And that gets reflected in many minds. Your mind, my mind. The reflections are many.
Okay.
The reflection is called Chidabhasa. Chitta. Mind is Chitta. So in the mind, there's a reflection of Chidakasha.
Okay.
So this reflected consciousness in the mind identifies with the body and mind. Atma doesn't identify. Atma is pure. So then you become Jiva. But you have to understand, I am not the reflection, I am the original. That's called liberation.
Prabhuji, that is, when we identify the reflected consciousness with with the actual, that is how it can be done, how it can be identified.
So, okay, just like, simple as looking at the mirror, right? So when you look at your face in the mirror, you are able to see the reflection, right?
Yeah.
So,
yes, sir.
Very nice. I am not very nice. Okay, you start confusing yourself with the reflection. So reflection you have to use, understand I am here. You cannot see yourself face. You have to use the reflection to recognize I am this here.
Okay. So actually the Chidakasha the Atman in us is the same, but because we cannot see it, we have to identify it with the reflected consciousness.
No, no.
And that is self-realization.
No, no. Reflected consciousness is what you are. One who is speaking is reflected consciousness.
Okay.
Okay. But the reflected consciousness is same as the original consciousness. Same. The reflection is same as the sun.
Original.
But you are confusing yourself. Reflected consciousness is also alive. It's conscious. It is confusing itself with the body. So you have to say,
yes, sir, yes.
You have to understand, I am the sun. I am the consciousness. Not the body.
Okay.
But
so the reflected consciousness should not be identified with mind, body, mind, intellect.
Correct.
That is, yeah.
Okay. Okay. How do you do that? By seeing. Oh, I am seeing the body. That's why I am not the body. If I see something, I am not that.
Okay.
Right.
Yes, sir.
There's
yes,
a very, very different, very peculiar logic in Vedanta compared to psychology. Okay. In psychology, a patient goes to the doctor. Says, I am suffering. Okay? Then doctor says, oh, you are suffering? That's why you have a problem. Correct? So, doctor says, you are suffering, my mind is suffering, I have a problem. So, Vedanta says, oh, very good, your mind is suffering and body is suffering. That's why you don't have a problem, because you are able to see that. You are the seer. Whatever you are able to see and experience, you are not. Yes?
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Ravana? Got it?
Thank you, sir.
Yes, Guruji. So, when you were saying that as we are doing, you said see self as witness.
Yeah.
And not the doer.
Yeah.
So, then that is who is doing. And why is that doing?
Okay,
like,
so,
like,
okay, who is doer? You tell me who is the doer?
Is it the mind which is getting inputs through the senses and then operating?
Correct. mind is the instrument, but it's a very sophisticated automation instrument. So it gets the input from sense organs, it gets programmed and it runs the program, thinking that I am the running. Right? You see a jalebi. So then some triggering happens in the mind. Oh, nice. Let me eat it. Whereas consciousness just watches. The mind is functioning based on the vasanas. But because you are so associated with the mind, you think that you are doing it. You are not doing it, you are observing it. Got it?
Okay, but the self or Atma doesn't try to control the mind, saying like, don't do it or...
First of all, the self or Atma, what you call a self or Atma,